First, I'd just like you guys to both introduce yourselves and say a little bit about what you do on a day-to-day basis. Let's start with John, and then we can move on to Zach.
This is John Armstrong, and I'm the co-owner and COO of Pegasus Pictures. I'm from Brownsburg, Indiana. I graduated from Brownsburg High School back in the 90s, before you were probably born. And on a day-to-day basis, I recently moved back to Indiana last fall to kind of be the boots on the ground portion, the boots on the ground operator, so to speak, of our company. And on a day-to-day basis, I spin a lot of plates. We have always about a dozen projects in the works that require different management and correspondence and meetings and developments. And so I'm on the phone and at my computer and in meetings just about all day, every day. When we're filming a movie, then everything's off the table, and that's what we're that's what we're focused on.
Yeah, of course. And Zachary, what about you?
Yeah, hi. This is Zachary Spicer. I am a co-founder and CEO of Pegasus Pictures. And on a day-to-day basis, I talk to no less than probably 100 people, whether on the phone, through text message, or in person. And really work on, while John is focusing on the on-the-ground tasks and the community building there in Indiana, I'm working with a lot of our professional contacts in New York and Los Angeles, trying to get our movies out into the world as much as we can, and also talking to new people about bringing them into Indiana, new actors, new directors, new producers, new writers, of bringing new voices and new stories and everything back to back home.
Awesome. So you both have kind of a background in theater. And Zachary, you've majored in archaeology. What led you both to film and to Pegasus Pictures?
Well, I started making movies when I was about 8 years old. I used to run out into the backyard, and you won't know what this is, but there used to be a thing called a VHS camcorder. It weighed approximately 12 pounds, and it was terrible quality, but we used to make movies with those. And we would edit from VCR to VCR. And so I started making movies when I was really young, and it's always been a passion of mine. I went into college. I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do. I wanted to be Indiana Jones, but then I found out that wasn't a thing. And so I was actually cast in a show with John. I guess it was my junior year. And the show was guest directed by a director out of New York. And he told me that I should stop trying to dig stuff up. I should go to New York and try to be an actor. So I went. I just dropped everything and I went to New York. That was 12 years ago. And I've been working in New York over the past 12 years as an actor, predominantly. And then about 4 years ago, John and I again, we met back up in New York and started talking about this larger dream of being able to tell stories that we really cared about, and tell them with the people that we really care about. And so that's how Pegasus was born. This idea that we weren't going to wait for other people to give us permission to do what it was that we were so passionate about and what we wanted to put out into the world.
That's awesome. So I know you guys have kind of tried to connect with new talent and like the youth of Indiana. How do you guys do that? How do you connect and inspire Indiana's youth?
Well, it started with our first feature film. We filmed in Bloomington, The Good Catholic, and we partnered with Indiana University and set up an internship program with IU students to get some really practical, hands-on experience being on set, which is kind of a rare occurrence in Indiana. And it was such an amazing experience, not only for the students, but also for us and the local professionals that we hired. They really relished the opportunity to show younger people what they did and how things operated, because like them growing up, they also didn't have those real-world experiences. And so that's really how it started. And then we had this idea that we should try to expand that and try to reach younger students. So a couple of years ago, we developed our first high school project, which we lovingly call Project Pegasus. It's a statewide screenwriting competition where we submit, we take submissions of short screenplays from high school students all around the state, and we pick a winner, and we put together a professional film crew of Indiana artists and travel to the town of the students and produce the film. And it was an incredible experience. The first time we did it, the winner was young Kira Daniels from Madison, Indiana. So we spent about a week down in Madison working with the community, with professional filmmakers from all around the state and local young people to realize that project. And then this year we did it at Fishers High School. And Whitney Folk and Cynthia Folk and Whitney Roberts were the winners this year, co-writers. We filmed their movie in May. It's currently in post-production. So, and then what's really cool is from the internship pool on The Good Catholic, we paid interns in four different jobs on the second film as White Light. So not only did they get practical experience as an intern, but we actually hired them, and they got paid jobs on a second film. And that has happened again and again from our high school projects. People have come to intern with us and then get rolled into paid gigs. So we're setting up our own little farm system here where we should inspire young people but also train them and then put them to practical use on our set. And hopefully we inspire them to stay in Indiana and to keep continuing that work and building our base, or take that experience out to the world at large and show them the great things that they can do and have learned right here in their home state.
That's awesome. And just so everybody who's listening knows, you can find more out about Project Pegasus at projectpegasus.org. So what do you both think has been the most rewarding part of your job so far?
Well, for me personally, it is the Project Pegasus and the internship programs that we have with IU. Speaking for me personally, you know, when I was at IU and just in Indiana in general, filmmaking seemed like this larger-than-life goal that lived so far away from Indiana. If you wanted to do it, you had to go to New York or Los Angeles, and it wasn't something that was accessible to those of us that grew up in small towns in the Midwest. So to be able to have the kids in the high school project and the college students there learning from actual industry professionals day in and day out, and just seeing them realize that they're capable of the dreams that they have in their head, and that it's actually possible for everybody that actually wants to work in this industry and is willing to work hard and be a great person to work with on set and have original ideas and problem solve. Seeing that and that energy, I think, is really the engine that keeps all of us going because that's how we started out.
I'd have to agree that the learning process is really, really awesome. Working with young people, giving them experiences that they probably wouldn't have otherwise, and broadening their horizons a bit, and then showing, seeing them grow and their confidence and, you know, sense of self is really rewarding. The other rewarding thing I really like about our work, as film producers is the amount of engagement we have with people in the community. Coming from the theater, it's a different background in that you have to bring everyone to a central place to have an experience, which is certainly wonderful and something that we love to do. But film happens out in the world. It happens on location. And unless you're building your own set, you're filming on a live environment. Every place that we go is someone else's life. We get to go into their homes or their places of business and film there and work with them or their restaurant. And it's so great to connect with and collaborate with different people on different goals. And in ways that we just wouldn't otherwise. I've been in so many amazing conversations with people that I would not have otherwise met, who aren't filmmakers, just people in the world that I wouldn't have met otherwise if it weren't for the work that we were doing. So community engagement is really a rewarding part of being a film producer.
That's great. All right, so I have one last question. What upcoming projects are you guys really excited for people to see?
Well, the first, the next film that we finished after The Good Catholic is a film called Ms. Whitelight. It's a dark comedy drama that stars Roberta Calandrez, Judith Light, and John Ortiz. It's a really, really heartfelt film that explores the world of hospice and terminally ill patients. And it's we're really excited for people to get to see, specifically Roberta Calandrez. She does amazing work in this film and everything else that she works on. And then the film immediately after that was our third film. It's called The Miseducation of Bindu. It is starring Megan Suri and David Arquette, Priyanka Bose. And we shot all of that at Broad Ripple High School, which was just one of the coolest things in the world. So anybody that knows Broad Ripple or anything, they're gonna like a lot about that movie. But it's about a young Indian American girl who is experiencing her first year in the public school system and trying to navigate all the relationships around that. It's a really funny, really heartwarming coming of age high school comedy. And fortunately, that one we partnered up and we got. Is being produced by Mark and Jay Duplass, the Duplass brothers, which are huge heroes of ours. So we're excited for people to see that. And then, if that's not enough, as we begin our latest Project Pegasus, should be coming out later this year. And like John said, you know, written and by those two wonderful women, Hidden Fishers, and we got to shoot it there in the community. And it's really, really turned into a really sweet short film. So we're excited for that. And then all of, you know, next year's Project Pegasus.